करके स्वागत करें सभी लोग। एक प्रधानमंत्री जिन्होंने 80 करोड़ लोगों को मुफ्त में अनाज पेट भरने के लिए दिया है सालों साल मेरे भाइयों को।
On the campaign trail, we have caught up with Maharaj, as he's called popularly in these parts. Mr. Sindhya, your sense of how the voters in Guna are thinking about the elections this year?
I can't tell you that. I need to ask you that. You can't ask a candidate what he thinks. I think it would be very biased for me to tell you what I think. I must ask you for your feedback.
Okay, let me rephrase.
I don't believe in a candidate. Obviously, he's going to say every candidate says that. So I would rather reserve that for your judgment than mine.
Okay, let me rephrase that question. In decades, you've asked people to vote for you and press the panja button or the ballot be stamped on the panja, you know, chhap. This time you're telling them ki phool ka button dabaiye. Is it difficult? Are you worried that perhaps they would, you know, associate for you only with the panja?
Not at all. People have understood very clearly what has happened in the last 4 years. And I mentioned that in the on the stage as well, in the munch, while I was speaking. That a government that came in with a mandate to serve the people became a government that was only about vote, note and kursi. And that's why when they told me ki sadak pe aa jao, on the one hand Pradhan Mantri ji's leadership capability, I decided at that point of time that I need to serve the nation under his leadership, and therefore brought down the government and made sure that a BJP government was formed which has served the people. And people have understood that very clearly.
Were you also disenchanted because now Congress is in the dock for appeasement, for caste politics? You're mentioning those in few of your campaigns.
A country which is transporting itself under the Prime Minister's leadership and transforming itself into a Vishwa Guru. In that country, the agenda that the Congress has is caste politics. That is where the Congress wants to take this country, and this I.N.D.I.A. Gadbandhan, when India has transformed itself from the 11th largest economy into the 5th largest economy and by 2027 into the 3rd largest economy, the Congress is about taking it back 1,000 years. Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi is about taking the country forward into a leadership role on the world stage. That is the difference in the outlook between the Congress and the BJP. The Congress has become a party which is bankrupt of ideology, a party that is bankrupt of ideas, a party that is bankrupt of leadership, and a party that does not coexist with the idea of India anymore.
So in your campaign trail, you're campaigning throughout Madhya Pradesh also, there's no resonance that you find of this caste census, because the candidate against you also is on that line, on caste line.
The Congress party, which opposed the caste census, opposed the Mandal Commission, and it was a non-Congress government that brought in the Mandal Commission, today is talking in a forked tongue about a caste census. It needs to look at itself in the mirror.
Bharatiya Janata Party's election campaign seemed to be on the four new groups that the PM has spoken about, and as we are speaking, there are people here to welcome Mr. Sindhya. These are people in Guna who are welcoming him, and we'll try and resume the conversation after he's taken the blessings of these people. We are on the campaign trail with him. People of Guna call him Maharaj, and you can see the kind of affection that they are showering him with. Let's pan the camera once again to Mr. Sindhya. He's accepting the garlands from people, the adulation, and listen to his message. He says, "Saat tarikh ko jam ke vote dena hai." So repeatedly, this message is being given ki saat tarikh ko vote dena hai, kamal ka button dabana hai. That message seems to be going through, Mr. Sindhya. Group after group stopping you, and while their love and adulation for Maharaj is something that we have seen, it's a combined love affair. It seems Maharaj and Modi ji.
Well, first of all, I don't know who you're talking about because my name is Jyotiraditya Sindhya. Okay, very very clearly, it is Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi ji's vision for development that has translated into this electric relationship between himself and the people of the country. And that is what you're seeing a manifestation of even here.
All right. So what is it that Mr. Sindhya is getting for the people of Guna? I mean, you as a civil aviation minister?
As a civil aviation minister, yes. We've got an airport sanctioned in Guna, an airport sanctioned in Shivpuri. I've built the largest airport in Madhya Pradesh. in a record time of 16 months in Gwalior, 2.5 lakh square feet, 500 crores. Shilanyas was done on the 16th of October 2022, inauguration on the 10th of March 2024 by the Prime Minister, Shilanyas by the Home Minister, built in the shortest period of time in the history of independent India, such a large airport. And therefore, development all round, whether it's Civil Aviation Minister or the roads that you're travelling on, these roads have been built by me. There were, as I mentioned in my speech, pagdandis over here. There were no roads. Today, your camera is not shaking while you're travelling with me. And this was known as the Bimaru state. This was known as Ms. Shriman Bantadhar state. And today, look at the transformation that has happened.
So my final questions. What is Mr. Sindhya's plan? Once, if Guna votes you back to power, is there any project for nation building that you have in mind?
Development, development, development. Standing with the people in their time of need and being their son, being their brother, being one of them.
Mr. Jyotiraditya Sindhya has reached the next stop of his campaign trail. We'll let him go. But Mr. Sindhya, thank you so much for taking time out and speaking to CNN News 18.
In our campaign trail, we have been in Baramati for an entire day today and have been trailing Supriya Sule for almost 2 days now, travelling with her, seeing her campaigning across the constituency of Baramati, even as she crisscrosses the urban areas, the rural areas. I have with me Supriya Sule right now, who will speak about the several issues that dominate this Lok Sabha election, how this election is different from all the other elections that she has seen, and what will be the issues that will dominate for this term, the fourth term that she is seeking a mandate for. Supriya Sule, thank you so much for your precious time and speaking to CNN News 18.
My pleasure.
The one issue that consistently comes up and the one issue that the India bloc is also talking about now is with respect to the credibility of the EVMs. Recently, even Priyanka Gandhi Vadra raised questions about its credibility, saying that, there is a possibility of tampering there. And if the BJP has to cross 180, it will have to use the EVMs. At a time when the Supreme Court is also hearing a case about it, what is your view on it?
Well, it's very hard for me to actually, because, you know, people are throwing so much information at you with technology and with artificial intelligence. There's so much change in technology, it's alarming. And you hear things about hacking, which never existed a few years ago. And actually, I've won 3 times so on the same EVM machine. So it would be unfair for me personally to run it down completely.
Other issue that is being talked about is the electoral bonds. That, you know, in Maharashtra as well, we have seen a lot of topic. Discourse about it. The Uddhav Thackeray group has said Chanda Do Chanda Lo kind of a scheme. It's being called the biggest scam by the opposition. Prime Minister has said that this is the biggest exercise in transparency.
Not at all. I mean, he's the Honorable Prime Minister, and he's not only a Prime Minister of the BJP, he's a Prime Minister of India. So for me, very, very, with full humility and respect to the Honorable Prime Minister, I appreciate his point and I hear him out. But I still remember those days when somebody I dearly loved and respected is Sri Arun Jaitley. And Jaitleyji was somebody very, very close to all our hearts. We had ideological differences, but he was really our Mr. Popular. We loved him very, very dearly and we still love him and we miss him in Parliament immensely. But I remember when he brought in the bonds, we all debated with him very respectfully and said, Arunji, we really like you, we trust you. But this is something which is not going to work. And there were a lot of people across party lines who objected that this is going to be a scam. You're legalizing corruption.
I'm not sure if you'll like this question, but you are a personal favorite of Amit Shah's when he recently came to Maharashtra. He said it was your love that split the party. And it was the love for Aditya Thackeray that his father had that led to the split in his party. The two takeaways from that rally that he did in Maharashtra, one was asking your father what he did for Maharashtra in the last 10 years and saying that the BJP had no role in splitting the parties and that it was your love that the father had for you that led to the split. How do you look at this?
Well, I'm very amused and I'm eternally grateful to him there are three parts to the story. I'm eternally grateful to him because I'm free of the corruption charge. He used to come and say, naturally corrupt party, NCP. I'm free from that. So I feel great about it. You know, I feel, because I'm here to serve the country. And when the corruption is taken away from our name, I feel absolutely elated, overjoyed. That's point number one. Point number two, when he talks about putri prem, putra prem, who doesn't love their children? Yeah, I don't know anybody who doesn't love their children, and I'd never make it personal. So I'm amused by it. And of course, my parents love me. Huh? What's wrong with that? We all love our children.
We are in Malegaon Khurd, where we have been doing a campaign trail with Supriya Sule. This is a small sabha that was organized at the last minute after request by the villagers. We have been with her on the campaign trail for an entire day today. Among the several small sabhas that she has been holding from one village to another, we have now reached Malegaon Khurd in Baramati. I have with me Yuvendra Pawar, who is a family member campaigning for his aunt. Yuvendra Pawar, tell us, you know, the whole country is watching, the family is split in the middle. It's not just a political battle for you, it's a lot more personal.
See, I think it is more political. Our family, this is not the first time that people have had opposing or differing views, but it's the first time that a family member has been pit against another family member. So that is new for us. But say a family that has different views, that we've been used to. But this we felt is not correct. But hopefully, let's see, after the election, everything should go back to normal.
Continue with our campaign trail along with Supriya Sule. We have been trailing her for almost 2 days now. Let's ask her the next question, even as we are on the next phase of campaigning. Tai, the opposition parties have been fearing that if the BJP comes back to power, the constitution of India will change forever.
Absolutely. I mean, I completely agree, and I've been saying that all the time in most of my speeches. For the reason that two BJP MPs have said it, that abki baar 400 paar aur Savidhan badlayenge hum. So this is what two BJP MPs have officially said it. So it's obvious it's on their agenda. It's not an allegation, it's facts.
Do you think that religion will be an important issue in this election on the basis of which people will vote across the country?
I'm not so sure about that. But one thing I'll tell you, the economic issues are seriously challenging and they are alarming. And purely I'm going by data. I'm not going by just a critic. Please walk on the streets anywhere in India. Is unemployment a challenge? Yes, it is. Is price rise a issue? Yes, it is. Mehngai hui hai? Haan, zarur hui hai. And corruption is an issue they cannot walk away from.
Supriya Tai, you've been very candid and very kind with your time. Thank you so much for your time, and we wish you all the best through these elections. So this was an entire day spent with Supriya Sule campaigning on her campaigning trail in the constituency of Baramati. We thank her for her precious time, even as we wish her luck for the elections. With video journalist Manish Dubey, this is Vinaya Deshpande from Baramati.
Party, Janta Party!
Amethi se ab Rahul Gandhi lad rahe hain kya? रण छोड़ भाग हमें दीजिए बाय नाट
Ghar. That Mama would have been a chief minister again if politics had not shaped the course of his career otherwise. A four-time chief minister, six-time MLA, five-time member of parliament, Shivraj Singh Chauhan has thrown his hat into the ring yet again, this time wanting to become the member of parliament from Vidisha one more time. We've come on a campaign trail with Shivraj Singh Chauhan to understand how politics has shaped his life last 6 months. What does it take for a former chief minister to hit the ground asking to be made a member of parliament yet again?
इस बार लग रहा है रिकॉर्ड तोड़ मार्जिन से विदिशा जीत रहे हैं।
ये तो बहनों का आशीर्वाद है, मेरी बहनें आई हैं, आशीर्वाद देने, इनको ही काम करना है सब।
शिवराज सिंह चौहान has taken the chief minister's chair of Madhya Pradesh for decades, but this time he is in a new role. Joining us on this program is Mr. Chauhan. Mama ji, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया हमारे से बात करने के लिए।
धन्यवाद, आपका स्वागत भी है बेटी।
थैंक यू सो मच। हम ये जानना चाहते हैं कि इस बार विदिशा में तो आप सांसद का चुनाव लड़ रहे हैं, पर पूरे मध्य प्रदेश में और देश भर में भी आप घूम कर आए हैं। हमारे दर्शकों को बताइए, आपके हिसाब से मध्य प्रदेश में और देश में क्या चुनावी आकलन कर रहे हैं?
एक ही चीज है, अपने देश को आगे बढ़ते हुए देख के हर भारतवासी प्रसन्न है। फिर से तीसरी बार मोदी सरकार और अब की बार 400 पार, ये जनता का नारा बन गया है। मध्य प्रदेश में 29 की 29 सीटें भारतीय जनता पार्टी जीतेगी और देश में भी हम 370 बीजेपी और एनडीए 400 के पार जाएगा।
लेकिन कुछ लोगों का ऐसा कहना है कि एक डेमोक्रेसी में विपक्ष का होना बहुत जरूरी है, तो अगर मध्य प्रदेश में 29 की 29 सीटें भाजपा के पास है, देश में भी 400 सीटें भाजपा के पास है, तो आपको लगता है ये डेमोक्रेटिक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से ठीक है?
आप ये बताइए, भारतीय जनता पार्टी का काम थोड़ी है कि वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी के विरोधियों को मजबूत करे। क्यों विपक्ष इस स्थिति में पहुंचा? राहुल गांधी अमेठी छोड़ के भाग रहे हैं। अब जहां जड़ें थी, इंदिरा जी लड़ती थी वहां से, सोनिया जी लड़ती थी वहां से, तो जो कांग्रेस की ऐसी सीटें थी जो उसके प्राण हुआ करती थी, वहां उनकी जड़ें उखड़ गई और छोड़ छोड़ के भाग रहे हैं। क्या ये बीजेपी का दोष है? कांग्रेस अपने कुकर्मों के कारण इस दुर्गति को प्राप्त हुई है। ये बात सच है कि लोकतंत्र में विपक्ष रहना चाहिए, लेकिन विपक्ष काम ही ऐसे कर रहा है कि जनता उसको पूरी तरह से साफ करने में लगी हुई है।
यही मेरा सवाल था कि अगर कांग्रेस पार्टी और कांग्रेस पार्टी के लोगों में इतनी दिक्कत है, तो आप कांग्रेस मुक्त भारत बनाते बनाते कांग्रेस युक्त बीजेपी कैसे बनाने लगे?
भारतीय जनता पार्टी राष्ट्रीय पुनर्निर्माण का आंदोलन है, अभियान है, एक वैभवशाली, गौरवशाली, संपन्न, समृद्ध और शक्तिशाली भारत के निर्माण के लिए हम काम कर रहे हैं। अब इस काम में जो जुड़ना चाहता है भारतवासी, उसका स्वागत है, वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी में आए। विचारवान कांग्रेस बीजेपी में आ रहे हैं, हम भारतीय जनता पार्टी में शामिल कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि वो देश के प्रगति और विकास के साथ मोदी जी के साथ जुड़ना चाहते हैं, अपने देश को आगे बढ़ाने में योगदान देना चाहते हैं।
क्या कमलनाथ जी भी इसका भी स्वागत होगा?
ये तो गुण और देश दोष पर पार्टी तय करेगी, लेकिन इतना मैं कहता हूँ, कमलनाथ जी की विश्वसनीयता बुरी तरह से खंडित हुई है। लोगों का उन पर भरोसा ही नहीं है कि ये पता नहीं कब छोड़ जाए, ऐसी हवा उड़ रही, तो हम कांग्रेस में क्या करेंगे?
तो छिंदवाड़ा में इस बार कमल खिलेगा, आप ऐसा कह रहे हैं?
छिंदवाड़ा में कमलनाथ जी नहीं, भाजपा का कमल खिलेगा।
तमिलनाडु और केरला में भी आपको लग रहा है आपकी पार्टी डेब्यू कर पाएगी, सीटें मिलेंगी?
भारतीय जनता पार्टी तेजी से दक्षिण में बढ़ रही है, मोदी जी की लोकप्रियता पूरा पश्चिम, उत्तर, दक्षिण चारों दिशाओं में है और दक्षिण में भी हम शानदार सफलता प्राप्त करने वाले हैं।
मेरा आखिरी सवाल सर, मुझे मालूम है आपको देर हो रही है, बट आखिरी सवाल, आप पहले सांसद रह चुके हैं, आप मुख्यमंत्री रह चुके हैं, आप विधायक रह चुके हैं, फिर से एक बार सांसद के चुनाव में आ रहे हैं, अपने आप को क्या आप सेंटर के किसी रोल में देखते हैं? आपके आपके सपोर्टर्स चाहते हैं कि आप सेंटर में एज अ
क्या? एक ही रोल, भारतीय जनता पार्टी का कार्यकर्ता, पार्टी जो काम देगी वो पूरी समर्पण, निष्ठा, परिश्रम से मैं करूंगा।
शिवराज सिंह चौहान इज एमिंग टू विन विदिशा बाय अ रिकॉर्ड मार्जिन एंड परहैप्स टू गिव अ मैसेज दैट ही कैन ऑन हिज ओन नॉट जस्ट इंश्योर विन फॉर बीजेपी हियर इन मध्य प्रदेश बट ऑल्सो विन द सीट फॉर हिमसेल्फ बाय अ रिकॉर्ड मार्जिन। विल ही सक्सीड? ओनली द वोटर टर्न आउट एंड द वोटिंग डे विल टेल अस। विद अर्पित सेठ फ्रॉम विदिशा, दिस इज अरुण।
और Dimple ji, thank you so much for speaking to us.
Hi,
Avandika. CNN News 18.
Thank
you. So lovely to have you. I know you've really been very busy. So once again, thanks.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So let me begin by asking you, Dimple ji. It was in 2022 that you won the parliamentary by-election and that you won it by a huge margin, recording a thumping victory by over 2.88 lakh votes. Your party workers are extremely excited and very confident that it's going to be repeated again and by a far bigger number. How are you feeling about it?
It's a good election and I believe in Mainpuri, it's not about like election alone, you know, because it has been Netaji's constituency for a very long time and people are very attached. And from that perspective, they see me as Bhabi and Bahu. So I'm getting a lot of love and respect.
Your opponent, Mr. Jaiveer Singh, who was the Tourism Culture Minister, he is contesting against you. How do you assess his chances of winning from the Samajwadi Party bastion, from where the BJP has never won before? He says he's a very familiar face, he's a local face, he's someone who comes armed with development works, welfare schemes of the centre. How do you respond to that?
It's like, I don't think so. It's anything about that. Because he's a minister and he had been in Samajwadi Party at some point of time in his political career. And but there's nothing much about development or helping the people out in the constituency. And a large number of people, they're not happy with them. Mm-hmm. And we are hoping that we are going to win with much larger margins.
You know, your party has been calling it BJP's act of just being discrimination. And I mean, the Congress party very unequivocally has said that it's divisive, it's discriminatory. Your party has said it's diversionary. These are, you know, just tactics being adopted by the BJP. Why is it that the Samajwadi Party is so resistant to the implementation of this act?
See, it took them 10 years to get it and to implement it, you know. So I sincerely believe that every time election is on the way, the BJP people always want to deflect from the basic situation and scenario at the ground.
Recently, the Samajwadi Party also released their manifesto. BJP also released their manifesto. Samajwadi Party, in fact, Akhilesh ji did say that this is a jumla patra, it's a document of political rhetorics. Do you feel that there is no one to hold the government accountable for the fulfillment of guarantees? Do you feel that's why you know, you've been calling it a jumla patra?
It is a jumla patra because whatever manifestos they have been given the past elections, I don't think much of it have been fulfilled, you know. And every time you come up with the new manifestos and you deviate from your olden manifestos, so I think people are understanding that now and they are realizing it, and we are fighting a good election and the good results. We expecting good results as well.
There is one issue that I know you feel very strongly about, and you have talked about this as well, the issue of triple talaq. That's what the BJP has been harping on, that hum ye lekar aaye hain, we are the ones who have brought about the change, we are the ones who are standing for women's rights, accusing your party of, you know, playing vote bank politics and not really addressing the grievances of women who have suffered as a result of triple talaq. What do you have to say about that?
It's not a matter of triple talaq alone. You look at the situation of Uttar Pradesh right now. The statistics which are available with the NCRB records, you know, shows a continued deterioration of women in Uttar Pradesh, especially from the crimes perspective. You know, it's gone worst.
What was the Samajwadi Party's thinking of getting into an alliance with the Congress? Because we didn't see anything materializing out in 2017. The Prime Minister just not said recently that, you know, this is a film, ye do shehzado ki film chal rahi hai, then it was UP ke ladke. One had thought that your alliance with the BSP had actually yielded better results. So why
I think the alliance with the Congress was going to yield best results. So
why do you say that?
It's going all well, you know. It's gone down well with the people of the state, and everyone is supporting from we are getting support from every strata of society.
You and Akhilesh ji are literally, you know, you call the power couple, a very popular couple in UP circles. How do you both balance and juggle your lives, both of you? you know, having these very strong personalities and also very powerful roles. You have to manage the home, your electorate, the family, the party. How is it? How is that? How do you do this so well?
I think Akhilesh is 90% into all these things, and hardly 10% is what like we get out of his time. And for me, it's like 50-50 right now. So I don't know how things unfold in the future.
Wonderful. Dimpleji, thank you so much for
thank
your
you
time.
So much. Thank
it's
you.
It's been an absolute pleasure speaking to you.
Same here, Vartika. Thank you. Thank you so much.